Good morning, students. Today we are going to start our fourth chapter, that is traffic engineering. Okay, in that we are going to discuss about scope, speed studies, origin and destination studies. Okay, so in this lecture series of transportation engineering, we already completed three chapters. In that is last chapter is highway materials. In that we are discussed about the soil, aggregates and binders such as bitumen, tar, asphalt, etc. In this lecture we are going to discuss about traffic engineering, scope, speed studies, origin and destination studies, etc. Okay, so let's start with the traffic engineering. The traffic engineering, it is the science of measuring traffic and travel, the study of the base laws relating to traffic flow and generation, and application of this knowledge to the professional practice of planning, designing and operating traffic systems to achieve safe and efficient movement of persons and goods. Then what are the objectives of traffic engineering? To achieve efficient, free and rapid flow of traffic. Second, to reduce the number of accidents. Okay, then various phases of traffic engineering are 3 E's, that is engineering, enforcement and education. So in engineering, constructive, okay, that is geometric design of road, enforcement, traffic laws, regulations and controls, and in education, publicity and through school and television has been included. Okay, then scope of engineering. Traffic characteristics, improvement of traffic facilities, that is vehicle, human, road users, etc. Then second scope of engineering, traffic engineering, is traffic studies and analysis. Third, traffic operation control and regulation, that is laws of speed limit, installation of traffic control devices has been included in traffic operation control and regulations. Planning and analysis. For planning and analysis, traffic engineering is most important for the roads. Geometric design, that is horizontal and vertical curve design. Then administration and management, that is 3E concepts. Okay. Then traffic characteristics. First, road user characteristics, that is physical, mental, psychological, environmental, are the most important characteristics. Then vehicular characteristics, vehicle dimension, weight of loaded vehicle, power of vehicle, speed of vehicle, braking characteristics, etc. Okay, then traffic studies. Why it is necessary or why it is very important to do the traffic studies? Okay, traffic studies are carried out to analyze the traffic characteristics. These studies helps in deciding the geometric design features, traffic control for safe and efficient traffic movement. The various traffic survey studies generally carried out are, first, traffic volume survey, that is traffic volume study, speed study, in that spot speed study and speed and delay study has been included. Then origin and destination study, traffic flow characteristics, traffic capacity study, parking study, accident studies. These are the studies which are generally carried out. Then first, traffic volume study. What do you know about traffic volume study and why it is necessary or why it is due? Okay, so traffic volume study is nothing but the number of vehicles crossing a section of a road per unit time at any selected period. It is the number of vehicles crossing a section of road per unit time at any selected period. It is used as a quantity measure of flow. The commonly units are vehicles per day or vehicles per hour. Okay. The objects and the used of traffic volume study are, what are the main objects are? It is generally accepted as a true measure of the relative importance of roads and in deciding the priority for improvement and expansion. Then it is used in planning traffic operation and control of existing facilities and also for planning the new facilities. It is used in the analysis of traffic patterns and trends. Okay. It is also useful in structural design of pavement, used in planning one-way streets and other regulatory measures. Then turning moment study used in the design of intersections, in planning signal timings, channelization and control devices, etc. Pedestrian traffic volume study is used for planning sidewalk, crosswalk, subway and pedestrian signals. Then how can we count the traffic volume? Counting of traffic volume. First mechanical count or second manual count. First mechanical count. In this may be fixed type or portable type. It is automatically record the total number of vehicles crossing a section of the road in a desired period. Other method of working the mechanical detectors are by videos or radar detectors. Advantage is that it can work throughout the day and night for the desired period. It is the advantage. That is, it can be work throughout the day or night for the desired period. And the second manual count, it is possible to obtain data which cannot be collected by mechanical counter, such as vehicle classification, turning moment, etc. Okay, this is the main advantage of manual count. Then presentation of traffic volume data. First, average annual flow, that is vehicles per year. Then second, annual average daily traffic, annual average daily traffic or annual average daily traffic. Average daily traffic represents the total traffic for a year divided by 365 or the average traffic volume per day, that is vehicles per day. Hourly average traffic, vehicles per hour. And the 30th highest hourly volume or the design hourly volume is found from the plot between hourly volume and the number of hours in a year that the traffic volume is exceeded. The 30th highest hourly volume is the hourly volume that will be exceeded only 29 times in a year, and all other hourly volumes of the year will be less than this volume. The 30th highest traffic volume is found to be satisfactory from both facility and economic considerations. Then we are going to discuss about the speed study. After traffic volume survey or traffic volume study, we are going to discuss about the speed study. What do you know about speed study? First, spot speed. It is the instantaneous speed of vehicle at a specified location. That means at a specified location, what is the speed of a vehicle? Okay. Then average speed. It is the average of spot speed of all vehicles passing at a given point on the highway. Okay. Then next, space mean speed. Harmonic mean. Average speed of vehicles in a certain road length at a given instant, that is given by the formula Vs is equal to n divided by summation of I to n 1 divided by phi I, where Vs is equal to space mean speed, n is equal to number of vehicles and V is speed of the vehicle. Vs is equal to nl divided by summation of 1 to n ti. Okay. Time mean speed, arithmetic mean, that is mean speed of vehicle at a point in space over a period of time, or it can also be defined as the average of instantaneous speed of observed vehicles at the spot. We can get the time mean speed, that is arithmetic mean, by the formula Vt is equal to summation of Vi to the range 1 to n divided by n, where Vt is equal to time mean speed, n is equal to number of vehicles, and V is equal to speed of the vehicle. Then next term is running speed. It is the average speed maintained by vehicle over a particular stretch of road while the vehicle is in motion. This is obtained by dividing the distance covered by the time during which the vehicle is actually in motion. Okay. Then next term is journey speed or travel speed. It can be defined as the effective speed with which a vehicle transfers a particular route between two terminals. It includes delay and stoppage. Okay. Travel speed is nothing but the effective speed which is vehicle travels a particular route between two terminals. Okay. And in that, it includes delay and stoppage also. Then what are the types of speed study? We can divide it in two parts, that is two types: spot speed study and speed and delay study. Okay. So use up spot speed study first to use in planning traffic control and in traffic regulation. Second, to use in geometric design for designing the existing highway. Third, to use in accident studies. And fourth, to study the traffic capacity. Okay, these are the use of spot speed study. Then speed and delay study. This is the second type of speed study. Speed and delay study. The speed and delay studies give the running speeds, overall speeds, fluctuations in speeds and the delay between two stations of a road. Second, it gives the information such as amount, location, duration and cause of delay in the traffic stream. Third, the result of the spot and delay studies are useful in detecting the spot of congestion. Okay. Then next, four, the delay or time lost traffic during the travel period may be either due to the fixed delay or operational delays. Then next, fifth, fixed delay occurs primarily at intersections due to traffic signals and at level crossings. Next, operational delays are caused by the interference of traffic movement, such as turning vehicles, parking vehicles, pedestrians, etc. This is all about the speed and delay study. Then presentation of spot speed data. Okay, presentation of spot speed data. You can see the graph is plotted with the average value of each speed group on x-axis and the cumulative percentage of vehicles traveled at or below the different speeds on y-axis. From the graph, that is cumulative frequency distribution curve, following can be obtained: 98th percentile speed design speed, 85th percentile speed maximum speed, 58th percentile speed median speed, 58th percentile speed minimum speed. Okay. Then model average speed, that is frequency distribution curve. A frequency curve of speed, spot speed, is plotted with average value of each speed group of vehicle in x-axis and the percentage of vehicle in that group on the y-axis. Okay. Then the speed corresponding to peak value of curve is denoted as model speed. This is the figure which shows the spot speed survey. Okay. Then methods of speed and delay study. There are five methods of speed and delay study. First, floating car or riding check method. Second, license plate or vehicle number plate method. Then third, interview method. And fourth, elevated observations. And fifth, photographic technique. You can see the images of speed and delay study on the screen. Then first, floating car or riding check method. Floating car or riding check method. In the floating car method, a test vehicle is driven over a given course of travel at approximately the average speed of the stream, thus trying to float with the traffic stream A number of test runs are made along the study stretch. A group of observers record the various details. One observer is seated in the floating car with two stopwatches. One of the stopwatches is used to record the time at various control points like intersections, bridges, or any other fixed points in each strip. The other stopwatch is used to find the duration of the individual delays. The time, location, and cause of these delays are recorded by the second observer. The number of vehicle overtaking the test vehicle and the overtaken by the test vehicle are noted in each trip by third observer. Next, the number of vehicles traveling in the opposite direction in each trip is noted by fourth observer. In this method, the detailed information is obtained concerning all phases of speed and delay, including location, duration, and causes of delay. This is the floating car or riding check method of speed and delay study. You can get the formula for floating car or riding check method, that is T bar is equal to TW minus NY divided by Q, or Q is equal to NA plus NY divided by TA plus TW, where T dash equal to average journey time in minute, Q is equal to flow of vehicle in one direction of the stream, NA is equal to average number of vehicles counted in the direction of the stream when the test vehicle travel in the opposite directions, NY is equal to the average number of vehicles overtaking the test vehicle minus the number of vehicles overtaken when the test is in the direction of Q. Then TW is equal to average journey time in minute when the test vehicle is traveling with the stream Q. TA is equal to average journey time in minute when test vehicle is running against the stream Q. We can take the example for floating car method. The consolidated data collected from speed and delay studies by floating car method on a stretch of urban road of length 3.5 km running north-south are given below. Okay, so determine the average values of volume journey speed and running speed of the traffic stream along either directions. You can see in the table the trip number, direction of trip has been shown, journey time minimum per second, minutes, seconds. Total stop delay, minutes, second has been given. Number of vehicles overtaking has been given. Number of vehicles overtaken has been given. Number of vehicles from opposite direction has been shown. Okay, so we have to solve this to calculate the average value of volume, journey speed, and running speed of the traffic stream along either directions. So from the table, direction, journey time, spot delay, minimum second per taken, number of vehicles overtaken and in opposite direction has been shown. So total mean south north has been calculated. Okay, from the table, and we can get the values. The next, origin and destination studies. The object of this study is to plan the road network and other facilities for vehicular traffic. Plan the schedule of different modes of transportation for the trip demand of commuters. It gives the information like the actual direction of travel, selection of routes and length of trip. Then it is used in planning new highway facilities and in improving some of the existing system. Next, to plan the transportation system and mass transit facilities in cities, including route and schedules of operation. To locate expressway or major routes along the desired lines. Okay, then to locate terminals and to plan terminal facilities. Then to locate new bridge as per traffic demands, to locate intermediate stops of public transport. Then methods of origin and destination survey. Methods of origin and destination surveys. There are different methods of origin and destination surveys, such as roadside interview method, license plate method, return postcard method, tag on car method, home interview methods. These are the five methods of origin and destination surveys. You can see in the graph on the screen, origin and destination survey has been shown. Okay. So thank you very much. In this lecture, we are discussed about the scope of traffic engineering and the different types of speed study and speed, traffic speed, etc. Okay. Thank you. Thank you very much.